In this presentation, we're going to look at fitting a dry lined box into a dry line wall, sometimes called a stud wall. So it's a hollow partition wall. We're going to use the skills in order to fit that in the wall to facilitate a new socket. This presentation isn't about wiring the socket, it's purely about cutting the box into the stud wall itself, or dry lined wall, whatever you want to call it. So this box cut into this wall. Okay, we're going to look on the other side and see how we're going to make sure that we don't clash with any of the struts. We can't see any of the upright supports. They are metallic in this installation, but we can't see them. We presume there's one here to hold the frame. We presume they'll use a 400mm gap, but we need to be a little bit more precise before we start cutting a hole in the wall that potentially will hit one of those struts, and obviously be then unsightly and have to be patched and the box be moved. So we'll have a look on the other side of the wall and see how we can work out where we're going to put it this side of the wall, not to clash with any of those struts. So I come to this side of the wall where the socket that's on the ring final circuit is going to have the spurred socket on the other wall run from it. I've isolated the socket here, used a safe isolation procedure as discussed in a previous video presentation. It's off and isolated. I've removed the box from the wall so I can work out where the nearest strut is, or upright, to this socket outlet itself. So if I insert something rigid, in this case the 2.5 cable will be perfect, until it hits the side of the strut. So we've got it there, it's hit the strut that far away. If I use my socket outlet on the floor, I can put that down into position as if that was the upright, and then I can work out 400, which is roughly the gap they leave between the uprights. I can work out my 400, so between there roughly 400, position my box like so. The constant being the door frame, this side and next side, we can go and we can see at, for me, that's about 750mm to the box. The middle of the box should be here, which should be free from the strut here and free from the strut there. We still don't know it is, so we're going to be careful when we start marking out on the other side that we make sure there is no strut or cross member in there that could clash with the box. But that's a safe bet, we're going to be in a good area there, 750 in this case from the door frame. Into the bedroom that requires the additional twin socket outlet, and I'm going to measure 750 off the door, in this case comes to roughly about here, and the socket outlets in this installation are at a height of 450mm to the bottom to allow for people of limited reach, so complying with the latest standards of the regulation. So I'm going to install my socket in here. But I've got to confirm, first of all, when I mark around my box, that there is no other obstacles that could clash with the box when it enters the wall. Position my box on the wall at the correct height to the bottom of the socket, and this 750 measurement for me for hopefully missing the strut itself. I've checked it square, I can take a pencil and just draw around the box itself. Make sure you have the box the right way round. There is a raised flange on the front edge, and if you were to cut around that, that would give you some massive issues. I'll show you that in a sec. So I've drawn around the back of the box, not to draw around the front the other way around, obviously. We want a nice tight fit when the box goes in itself. So I've got my square drawn out now. I've got to confirm that I can take that out. So I'm ready to hopefully take up the square for the box for itself to support. Take my bradawl to start with, and I'll put some holes in here to confirm they go into the wall and therefore not clashing with any struts that could be behind. It's gone in on top right hand corner. Bang in the middle, bottom corners as well. I'll go top as well. Okay, so I've put a series of holes there to confirm there is no metalwork supporting the plasterboard in those areas. However, that's not enough. It could be that I'm vastly unlucky and the strut is actually this side, or potentially this side for the uprights. Therefore, when these boxes go in, they've got a side flap. This side flap is the one that needs to be, okay, protruding from the box itself, so it would actually sit there to hold it against the plasterboard. If it hits a strut, obviously we can't put those in and the box is in a position that's useless. So we would have to completely move it, and we've cut it out now. So we don't want to do that. So what I'm going to do is take a longer thin screwdriver and I'm going to just insert it so I can put it at an angle and go sideways. That one's gone in sideways, so I know I'm clear in that direction. And likewise, I'm going to take one this way and go sideways as well. So I've got it clear both sides as well. I'm pretty comfortable now that I can actually cut out the box itself. We're certainly not going to be attacking it with a fixed blade knife. I've seen some presentations where people start carving away with a fixed blade knife. We won't be doing that. That's how you slip and cut yourself or make a mess of the wall itself. So we're going to use the design tool, which is a pad saw, okay, in order to cut out the box itself. I've got to make one of these holes bigger in order just to get the tip of my pad saw in, and I'm just gently cut out the box. I like the box to be nice and tight, so I sometimes when I've cut it out, it doesn't quite fit in to start with, and just have to shave it back. That's not a problem. What I don't want to do is cut it beyond the lines and make it a lot bigger so the box obviously moves around. We don't want that. So let's open up one of these holes and then start the cutting process itself. So I'm going to open up one of the holes. Okay, I'm going to open up one of the holes with a screwdriver. So let me go with the screwdriver and then just take my pad saw and run around the lines that I've got. Just take your time, there's no rush, in order that I can stay on that line. Now the moment of truth, drop it out, fingers go that way, fingers go that way, and we haven't hit any of the struts. Obviously what you didn't see there when I was cutting out the box was the fact that wearing a pair of goggles, wearing a dust mask, okay, important to keep ourselves safe, and I wore both those during that part of the presentation. So box is ready to go in. I've taken out the two side clips which will facilitate the 3.5 box screws. Box clips into position, and then we simply just, I say simply, but we replace the side clips and new the case. And then they pull forward, locking the box in. So when the socket front goes on, the yellow side clip will pull up and pin between the plasterboard this side and the actual box, and then on the plasterboard this side and the actual box to hold it firmly into position. This is a level 2 assessment piece and is required to be done under examination conditions for us in the workshop. So let's run over the skills required to fit a dry line box into a dry line wall, something done very often on site with the fast new builds that are going up. A lot of the internal walls now are dry line walls, and these boxes are readily fitted in the industry. So they're the skills required for our level 2 assessment. I hope that's some help.